Well. Amazing nerds. What am I on here? What am I doing? Ooh. I'm going to look at Windows Server 2022. It says down here standard evaluation. Windows license valid for 180 days. And there are ways where you can extend it. I've heard of people using Windows Server for free for over a year. I don't know if you can use those extensions and shortcuts and stuff like that to do that anymore. Who knows? I actually like that background picture there. Again, this is just me having fun. This is just me wanting to see what the Windows Server world is all about, because I have used Linux as my home server for many years, and now we're getting this annoying fucking Edge setup here. You can install, while this is running, I will talk about the how you can install. You can install it either via a headless setup, you know, basically what most Linux distributions are installing Linux as for the server market, meaning that you get a headless install. You don't get a GUI and stuff like that. I just did this because you guys don't want to sit and watch me doing, you know, looking at the command line. There you go. There's not so much to show off there. But like I said, I've been using FreeNAS. I've been using Debian, Ubuntu server. Why can't I agree to this down here? That's currently what I'm using right now. I have a NAS server over there on the ground. I never ran Windows as a server OS. So that's why I like looking at it. I like to see what it's all about. And I have no understanding about Windows as a server operating system. I use Windows as a gaming platform. I've been using Windows since like the early 90s, basically, along with Linux. I always been told this, oh, if you want to set up a server, Linux is the way to go. It's more secure, it's more stable, blah, 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 blah. All of those sales point that people try to sell Linux as. And for that reason, I have used Linux as servers over the years to try it out. Never Windows. So this is really, really new territory for me. This is really, really fun for me. And already when it started up and you got this little program here showing up, I was already, wow, from a manager point. I'm not a manager, but for managing servers, because Linux, as far as I know, the closest to something in Linux is the OpenSUSE YAST application suite. And that's more setting up Linux and maintaining to some extent. They also have a command line version of YAST, but it's not nearly as fleshed out or as intuitive as this is here. I do honestly feel that in the Linux world, we love to complicate things because it looks us look smart. Okay? We love to make things seem like we are fucking Einsteins running a computer. When in a lot of instances, why not work smarter instead of harder? Why not work smarter instead of harder? It is a little bit slow in this virtual machine, I'm not going to lie. Here you can manage, you can add servers, there's tools here. Computer management, task scheduler. Let's look a little bit at that one. Oh, that's the same we have under Windows 10. This is, I think, based on Windows 10, if I'm not mistaken. Registry editor, services. Yeah, that's just the built-in Windows standard one. We have PowerShell. It's amazing, this little tool here. Yeah, we can even upscale it, which Linux really, really fucking need the proper scaling for high resolution displays. So this here kind of was like, wow, I kind of like that. There's, again, I just booted into it. It's in a virtual machine and it's going to be nuked, and I will reinstall Windows 10 because I always have a Windows 10 virtual machine to test out Windows programs and stuff like that. So it's really, really neat. And if you look at this here overview here, we'll go into one of the things that a lot of people say, oh, Windows is less secure than Linux. Linux is more secure by default than Linux is, or by design. I always have that mentality that yes and no. It all depends on where you are. I even though I'm not a professional system administrator or IT guy, I do talk a lot with IT people. I do talk a lot with people that administrate, deploy Linux servers and work with both Linux and Windows security. And all of them say that Linux get attacked and infected with malware just as much as Windows. They may not work as well under Linux, but nowadays in 2021, we're not in 2021, more and more viruses on the server front are working under Linux, or malware and attacks is actually successful under Linux. If you have a Windows and Linux ecosystem in your servers and you have, you know, getting attacked on your Linux machine, you'll be, hey, it's not working on my Linux machine. But what if that Linux machine or server is talking to your Windows servers? Then it becomes patient zero for all of the rest of your Windows ecosystem. This mentality that, well, we are Linux, we are bulletproof, and we should not care about security and attacks and stuff like that, especially in the corporate world, which I see a lot of people have that mentality. It's kind of like saying, I live in the woods, I will not close my doors because nobody's coming in here. And then one day you're laying asleep, fondling your genitals, and then the latest biker gang is standing in your living room and trying to take your television. Think about security. Linux being more secure than Windows on paper. Oh, Bixby just activated. So on paper, yes, it may be designed to be a little bit more secure out of the box, but we're talking 5% at most. Windows just seems to have a lot more neat things going forward when we are talking server. Windows just seems to do servers better than Linux from a end-user standpoint, from a convenience standpoint. I've watched plenty of Windows servers videos on the good old YouTube over the years, which I can't spell because I'm a stupid guy. So, oh my god, they also want us to agree to everything here. So if you go in here and you do Windows, oh, again, see, I can't spell. There are so many videos about how to administrate Windows servers, set them up, use them, run them, administrate them is the word I was looking for, and whatnot. And from what I have seen and what I hear people whisper into my fat ears is that administrating and running a Windows server is a little bit more convenient and easier than a Linux server in a lot of instances, because you have stuff like this and there's a lot of other things that's just more streamlined. You can do via the command line and all of those things. I won't go in and bore you guys to death with that. So what they are telling me is that, but for some workflows, yes, Linux may be a little bit more complicated, a little bit more efficient to administrate, but it's so much better or faster to run as a web server, file server, and stuff like that. So if you could take the ease of use and the convenience and merge that into like a Linux product, we would have like an operating system, in my opinion, that could take over the server world 100% almost. Because again, I hear a lot of people say that the reason they go with Windows Server in a lot of instances is stuff like this. It's convenient, it's manageable, you don't have to be a fucking computer scientist to run it. I could teach my brother to run a Windows Server with these tools here in like a week. But teach him how to administrate a Linux server with a headless environment, and he had to do all of these things via configuration files and stuff like that, would take him a lot longer. Will he have more power under Linux? Yeah, he would exactly know how to mess around with the system, how to tweak it, how to customize each little bit of it and stuff like that. But for a lot of people, they don't need that to run a server or an operating system for that matter. They just need, you know, the 10-foot view. And then when shit hits the fan, or if shit hits the fan, they call up someone, they pay a lot of money each month to, and they come and they're like, and then it's working. It's the same with Linux. Would I or could I run Windows as a server? I actually could, and I'm actually interested in doing it. From let me look at tell it like this. I'm not going to change out my FreeNAS, but it could be fun. I actually have a spare computer I could build. So build an extra server, just with one hard drive, and it could, like, let's say, save all my beach pictures of me looking really, really sexy in a board suit, for example. Just to see how it is to administrate it. Am I getting more attacked? Am I getting viruses? By only running... where the fuck is it? Here it is. By only running this here and not installing, you know, Norton antivirus or some of those big corporate antivirus programs. Is this enough? The built-in security for a home user, which I honestly think it is. I honestly think it is. We don't really need to even have ransomware protection down here. Us at home, we don't need much. So I have to think a little bit here because I am getting coffee and I'm all over the place and the time is not correct and I'm overwhelmed with options and new things. So I will just basically try and conclude this a little bit. So it's a little bit of a short video. If you want to see more about Windows Server, let me know. I will keep it up for a month or something like that and we can make more videos about it. Is this something you should look at if you're a Linux fanboy or a Mac fanboy? Yeah. You should definitely look at this if you are a Linux fanboy. You should definitely look at this if you hate Windows. You should definitely look at this if you are anti-Windows and whatnot. Why? Because you know how they work. You know how the competitor is functioning and working. It gives you a really, really good insight to how most of the world works and how most of the world use their computers. This is how most of the world is doing computers with a Windows, either desktop or server. You can't get around it. And if you're just going so, like this and pretend it don't exist, even if you're an IT professional or a hobbyist or just operating system interested, if you ignore Windows because, oh, they are evil and blah, 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 and I don't like Bill Gates and they are out to take my firstborn and if I'm running Windows Server, they will take my left kidney when I'm asleep and stuff like that. If that's your mentality, and therefore you never touch anything Windows, you, in my humble opinion, you cannot criticize something you know nothing about. Yes, you can go and watch a lot of videos about people running Windows or Windows Server and take their information in. You should watch those videos, you should listen to them. But the best experience that you can get is doing it yourself. I am not you. So how I look at the world and what I use my computers for and what I do with them may not, and definitely is not what you are doing. So for me, Linux servers and FreeNAS servers is perfect. There may be something those servers can't do that Windows can do for you, or Windows Server can do for you. This goes also into the corporate world. Especially if you're an IT professional, you should know Windows and you should know Linux. So you can have your own learned reasons for why you present a solution to a customer or to your employer or your boss or your manager, whatever it is. Be informed, listen, watch, learn, but also experiment, especially if you're an IT guy or you're a hobbyist. See you all later. Bye-bye.